Hello everybody, it's me, I'm Friendly Porcupine, and what I got for you today, long awaited, is the Green Contain. Call of Duty Mega Bloks knockoff. This time it's by the Xbox. Retailing for $4.99, I assume, and containing an unknown amount of pieces. Enough of that, let's begin with the review! So first things first, we have this nice little terrain piece. I have to say, it's more of a build than the last one I was reviewing. But, at least they give you a nice barrel and a few pieces. Problem is, this right here ruins this build a little bit because now figures can't really stand on. Kinda ruins that. Now, the one thing you've been all waiting for. The green crate. Is it good? Is it bad? Is it garbage? Let's find out. First of all, this is not according to official instruction, but the reason why I placed it up there, it just fits better. This piece, it stretches, but it does not, it's not good for standalone. This right here, we get this, I believe it says socks or sex force, I'm not sure. But yeah, you assume what it means, whatever. Regardless, just print here. It is a little, it's just like the other knockoff prints. It feels a little cheap, but it still does the trick. We look at something like this, I know, green crate. Mega Bloks does a much better quality job print. It doesn't feel cheap whatsoever. Here, it feels a little cheap, but still, it does the job. All of the pieces come apart like the regular, you know, container. You just have to be a little bit delicate, you see? Everything in here, it all take apart. So, but I said at least they knocked off there. Unfortunately, they did do. Oh yeah, here you can also place weapons. So they follow that. Unfortunately, problem comes when you start to close the crate. Look what happens. Look, you see it closes like this. Unfortunately, some of these things sometimes they come off a little bit, so you have to adjust. And the green one, let me compare with official Mega Blue. See, there is big difference. Here, peg hole. Here, no peg hole. This means that I can take something like this, a peg, and stick it through like that. See, it's not going to be big enough, which is a problem. And plus, problem number two, try opening this thing, it's hard. It's hard to get a good grip on it, you have to kind of feel it. Here versus Mega Bloks, you don't get that problem. You just grip and that's it, it opens up like that. Here you have this problem. If you have serious problem with opening this, right? Unfriendly Porcupine got you covered. Use toothpick method. Never ever fail. Just like that. It is a bummer about the crate, but whatever. Plus, when you close and open, it just tends to rip off easy. Which can be damaging. So, that's not very good on the build part. So this is figure number one. I have to say, they did a little bit better this time from previous. Especially with the vest. I don't know if you noticed, but it's actually gunmetal smack. That's right! With the same colors as just like the guns, you see the smack? It's exactly same color on vest. That's what I love a whole lot. Really glad these knockoffs finally learned how to do the smack right. So it definitely increases its aesthetic appeal. Articulation works just as well with the regular figures, just leg movement right here is a little limited compared to the Call of Duty. You have to build the figures up. Head mode right here comes off. Problem with this type of head mode skin specifically. Okay, you put it on, right? Look at that lack of articulation from movement. You can only move up that much. Take that to comparison of a real Mega Block Call of Duty figure. You have a lot more head articulation versus this right here. It's not that big of a deal, but when you play, it becomes a big deal. And here we have figure number two. This one is the special one because this guy, he comes with a hood, like he's in the hood, Assassin's Creed. But no, actually they took this just from like one of the Mega Bloks Call of Duty construct sets because if you take this head off, yes, you can take it off. you'll see that it works just the same way it works with any other light. So that's where they took the mold. I thought at first they made a new mold, but no. It's the Call of Duty one, so good thing I learned here. Plus, very infrequent that we get a nice red shirt like we do here. I really like how these knockoffs they're trying with deal different colors. Unfortunately, they still don't try hard enough because the arms are still wrinkled. They're cheap like that. Instead of giving you another arm mold, they just give you a wrinkly arm. Here, let me show an example of real Mega Bloc figure. So you see, are his arms wrinkly like the knockoff? No, they're straight. And best part is, even veiny in some circumstances, if you look at it right. These ones? No, not very well. So it's a problem. These are all the accessories you get in this set. To save your time, I decided to put it on white paper so you can see everything. Some accessories unfortunately don't operate so well. Like for example this sniper and flare gun because they're kind of difficult to grip. Some of these they just decided to rip it off of brick arm. Some of them I don't know exactly where they got it from. Some of them they also just ripped off from Call of Duty. Computer, unfortunately, if you close it, it gets stuck like that, but it does have detail. And plus, like I said before, all guns are smacked. Green backpack, which is something I like, and two figure stands that are just plain in color, ripped straight off from the Call of Duty line of Mega Blocks. Also not including the vest. Okay, everybody, it's that time of video game. Final judgment. For the aesthetics, I give this set an 8 out of 10. Why do I give this set an 8 out of 10? One, they at least have one eye application. It's not hold on this figure. Good job. Two, I love the hood. They at least tried to knock off a different mold and made it better. Three, I really love the vest. They made it gunmetal gray. Very nice. Four, they gave us a unique print. Yes, maybe not as good as Mega Bloc's Mega Constructs because they did a better job printing it, but still, it's different, so it's not bad. And my only, like I said, complaint, they don't do second eye application, but they've never done that, so it's okay, I let it slide. Plus, the guns, they look very accurate. And gunmetal gray, not bad. The arms, unfortunately, they're wrinkly, so yeah, wrinkly arm again. For playability, I give this set a 7 of them. Why do I give it a 7 out of 10? Very simple. These doors don't open up so very well. I wonder why. Why don't they open up so very well? Well, because of the design! That's why it don't open up so well. I can't even put a peg in there. That's stupid. Have to rely on toothpick in order to open it up. See, I got a tooth to pick with you. Yeah, it's below. At least they give you nice red guy, at least they give you this guy. Unfortunately, it's not painted, so it's bad. And the guns, they don't come apart. Like all of the other. No special knockoff troops. For value, I give this set a 9 out of 10 for value. Basically being about $5 a crate, like $5 for this container. You get a whole container which you can use to store a lot of these accessories, one. So think of it as a big humongous care package. Two, you get a lot and a lot of accessories. They're very generous on accessories, it's a whole lot. Yes, though given you have to take them out of the little nets, but you get a lot. Three, they give you two figures. You know what Mega Constructs decided to do with this? Only give you one. So I'm glad they at least still give you two, not bad. And for the build, I give the build an 8 out of 10. Like I said again, the doors, I include that as the build because since they didn't mold it so well, it kind of becomes strange. But they at least did a better job for this one. It at least something you can call a build. Some, at least. Unlike that gray container where you put fire in a barrel, that's it, no stuff. This at least everything speaks. So, give them that. And this takes us to our final score, which I give an 8 out of 10. Thank you for watching this video, everybody. I hope you learned something new, found this video useful, or, you know, it's cool. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a like. And if you wish to see more content from me, Friendly Porcupine,
You know what to do. Your mission is to subscribe, comrade. And I'll see you in the next mission. Next week. Goodbye for now, everybody. Here are some other videos you can watch if this one did not satisfy your entertainment.
Mega Block Water Bottle Challenge, no coffee this time. Bah. Bah. Bah.